The purpose of Krishna Avatara begins. After the death of Kamsa, his two wives, Asti and Prasti, returned to their father's place and submitted their misfortune to their father, Jarasandha. Jarasandha was the king of Magadha and Girivrajapura was his capital. Jarasandha's anger knew no bounds on hearing the fateful news. He wanted to take revenge. He collected an army of 23 battalions and marched on Mathura. Seeing the army besieging the city on all sides, Sri Krishna reflected for a moment. The purpose of my avatara is to relieve the burden of the earth, to destroy the wicked and protect the good. My work shall now begin. The king of Magadha has come with a big army. I shall destroy the army and leave the king alone. He'll come back with armies again and again, and I shall be able to destroy all such armies. Thus, a major portion of my work would have been accomplished. As he was thinking in this train, two celestial cars equipped with arms and armors of varied description arrived from the heavens in front of him. He showed them to Balarama and explained to him his plan of destruction. Fully armed, they both sat in the two cars separately and marched forward. They were not followed by any army. Sri Krishna blew his conch, Panchajanya, indicating his readiness to fight. Jarasandha asked Sri Krishna to move aside as he was too young to fight and invited Balarama to meet him. Sri Krishna told him that heroes did not boast of their valor, but exhibited it in their actions, and he started to attack. Sri Krishna and Balarama attacked the army from all sides and extinguished all the 23 battalions in a very short time. Balarama chased Jarasandha and caught him by the neck with his weapon called the plow and was about to smash his head. Sri Krishna ran to his side and prevented Balarama from doing any harm to him. He set free Jarasandha and advised him to go back safely, to collect fresh armies and return again to fight. Jarasandha was ashamed to be shown such mercy by Sri Krishna. He returned home determined to perform even tapas and defeat Sri Krishna. His friends joined him on the way, and at their instigation, he again collected 17 battalions every time and attacked Mathura for 17 times. And at every attack, his armies were routed and he was sent back with empty hands. For the 18th time, he was making great preparations for a final attack with a larger and greater army. Meanwhile, there was a cruel king called Kalayavana, who was not a Hindu. He was a great terror to humanity. Sage Narada approached him and began to describe to him the greatness of Sri Krishna and his accomplishments. Slowly, he instigated him to attack Mathura so as to establish his own greatness. Kalayavana started with a great army and besieged Mathura. Sri Krishna observed the new development. He consulted Balarama and decided to evacuate Mathura, lest Jarasandha also should come with his army, which he was sure to do in the next few days. And when the two brothers were engaged in defense, one of the armies might plunder the city. So Sri Krishna requested the ocean god to spare a piece of land of 100 square miles in the sea for the construction of a new city. He engaged the celestial engineer Vishwakarma and a city was ready overnight. By his yoga maya, Sri Krishna shifted all the inhabitants of Mathura to the new city, which was named Dwarka. One fine morning, Sri Krishna appeared outside Mathura, beautifully dressed and decorated with garlands. He was holding no weapons in his hands. He marched forward all alone out of the city, moving with a majestic gait. Kalayavana, who had been waiting outside the city for so many days, was astonished to see a single person of greater splendor, unarmed and unprotected, coming out of the city. He was enchanted by the beauty of the person. He remembered the words of Narada and decided that the man must be Sri Krishna and wanted to catch him alive. He pursued him on foot. Sri Krishna moved on with the swift feet and began to dodge the adversary by stopping here and resting there, and appeared as though he was within reach. Thus, Sri Krishna led Kalayavana far, far away and approached a big cave in a mountain. As Kalayavana was observing, Sri Krishna entered the cave and marched deep inside it. Kalayavana also entered the cave. At the entrance, he saw a man lying down fast asleep. He thought him to be Sri Krishna, who, being tired, must be taking rest, and so kicked the person with his legs. The sleeping man woke up due to the disturbance and looked at Kalayavana, who was standing by his side. As he looked at him, Kalayavana was burned to ashes in a moment due to his own evil deed.